Becoming a front-end developer takes time, but what if you could double your productivity with just a few simple habits? For most developers, this seems a dream, but it's actually quite simple. All you need is the 11 tricks that I'm about to share with you, and one of them is quite interesting. Trip number 3 will be to get you bored. Interested? Let's jump right into it. Becoming a front-end developer indeed does take a lot of time. I've been doing this for more than 11 years. So here are my 11 tips and tricks so you can become a better front-end developer. And first one on the list is think long-term. You're in it for the long run. As I've been doing a lot of mentorings, I've seen a lot of developers taking it the shorter route. They want to have real, immediate, actionable, like a UI, for example, but that's not it. You have to go for the long run. You have to evolve, you have to learn, you have to do this over the years, and therefore you have to have the mentality to do that. You just don't want to have a simple small little trick that you can have on that UI. You want to understand how that UI works. You want to make sure that that UI will make sense and also it will work after a few years also. Number 2 is embrace failure. Now, you want to embrace failure because you will definitely fail quite a lot. There will be bugs, there will be mistakes, and what you want to do is learn from them. You want to have a mentality that you want to fail as often as you can, most specifically at the beginning, so you can learn quite a lot. Also, make sure that you learn from others. Take a look at other people's code. Try to figure out how they might have messed up or why it's not working as it should be. So make sure that you learn from your failures. Number 3, get bored. Now, this is interesting. Create an environment where you actually get bored, because we are constantly bombarded with information and we do not filter most of it. We want to get bombarded with information. We do like interesting new stuff, whether it's a scroll feed or whatever interests our minds. So make sure whenever you start coding, you will get into a mindset where you are bored. You are not distracted. Therefore, you will 100% focus on the job at hand. Therefore, you will learn quite a lot. So that's why you want to create an environment where you are actually bored. Get bored. Number 4, read, then watch, then build, and then teach. Or you don't have to make sure that it's in this order, but what I mean here is reading is a little bit less than watching. Watching is a little bit less than building out apps. What I'm talking about is, of course, building apps. And building apps is a little bit less than teaching them. So if you know how to teach one concept, one particular thing that you are really accustomed to, do go ahead and teach it to somebody. First of all, you will help that person and it will be really, really satisfying. That person will be grateful. Maybe they will help you out on some other project. And second of all, you will have to distill your knowledge in a way that you can actually make that thing understandable. You have to teach that new thing. So therefore, you will know how that actual concept or whatever UI you want to build out actually works under the hood, how it really, really works. Now, number 5. You want to get a mentor. Now, I do have my own mentorship. It's at rebeloper.com/mentoring, where you can meet me on a one-on-one 60-minute Zoom call. But why is mentorship so important? Well, it will cut out days, if not months, of your, I don't know, tinkering, playing around, trying to figure out stuff. And most importantly, you will have a guide. Now, a guide is really important because information is out there and it's quite a lot. You want to know what you want to learn and how you want to learn it, and a mentor is a great way to do that. Number 6, I'm calling this the 5-minute developer, because we all have really busy lives. Maybe you have a job and you are doing this as a side hustle. Maybe this is just a hobby for you. You have family, you have other stuff to take care of. Maybe you have a pet, maybe you want to travel. So I have come up with this 5-minute developer thought, where all you have to do, if you have 5 minutes, just go ahead and sit down and do some work, learn something, build something, watch a YouTube video, take a look at a tutorial or something like that. If you have 5 minutes, go ahead and grab that those five minutes and learn something new, build something new. I often do this as I have a lot of meetings, I have a lot of work to do. If I have 5 minutes, I go ahead and do whatever I can do to improve myself in 5 minutes. Okay, number 7. Now, as you most probably know, I'm all about SWIFTUI. This is at the end of the day a channel about iOS development. I do love SWIFTUI as a front-end developer tool. But you want to make sure that you don't get the hype only about SWIFTUI. You don't get just a button or a text view. You want to make sure that you learn the fundamentals, and that's the data. Data-driven SWIFTUI, I would rather say that SWIFTUI is basically data UI, because data is what carries all of the interactions, all of the data, the UI changes from the data changes. Therefore, I would highly encourage you again to take a look at rebeloper.com/mentoring, when I can teach you the real fundamentals of data in SWIFTUI. Number 8. Do it every day. Now, this is no-brainer. You have to be really consistent. Here comes in the 5-minute developer. If you have 5 minutes a day, then you can do this every day. And I've been doing this each and every day without, well, maybe I skipped a few days in the last 11 years, but I've been doing this consistently, and that really, really builds up. So do it every day. Number 9. Build your own tools. Yes, once you start taking a look at tutorials, building out those tutorials and coming up with some techniques, you want to create your own tools, because therefore you know how those tools make your lives better. Of course, you know what's troubling you, what that bug is, or how you think that you can make this even better or faster. Therefore, you want to just create a simple tool that will handle that. And of course, if you know that tool is really, really important, it may help the community do what I do. I just sell them on my site. It's at store.rebeloper.com. Go ahead and check them out. There are a lot of tools. Just to name a few, navigation, Toast, routers. Go ahead and check them out. Maybe you have some ideas that you can build out your own. Okay, number 10. Get accountability. Now, this is important because us developers, it's kind of a lonely job. We sit at the desktop and nothing really happens. We don't interact that much. So we kind of slack off over time. That's where my community comes in. Go ahead and check it out. It's rebeloper.com/community, where you can be accountable and you can check on others also how they are doing, because this is a real powerful tool. If you say that you are going to build something out and you say this to someone, for example, that you care about, that you care about their opinion, you will fulfill that promise, of course. And if you say that you are going to learn, for example, SWIFTUI, I don't know, in 2 to 3 months, they will be there for you to check in, how are you going with that learning? Okay, and finally, number 11, and this is much about learning, a little bit more about how to get better at learning how to code, and that's active recall and spaced repetition. And before I dive into explaining what active recall and spaced repetition is, I would like to tell you that there's an app for that. It's called Anki. It's on the App Store. It does have a web version also. It's not sponsored. I do really like it. So active recall and spaced repetition. Basically, active recall, what that means is that you want to actively recall what you have learned. Take a look at some flashcards, for example. If you write down your question And on the other side, you write down your answer. After a while, you take a look at the question and you want to actively recall the answer for that question. And Anki does a great job with that. It does have these flashcards incorporated into them. Now, spaced repetition means that, let's say you have a question and answer card there and you just leave it for one day. Now, after one day, if you read the question and you know the answer, then you are going to leave it for 3 days and then 7 days, 14 days, maybe 16 days. It's like you just push it off till you kind of memorize all of it. Now, the cool part here comes when if you don't recall what you want to learn, you don't know the actual answer, well, then you are back to square one. You put it back to square one. Let's say on day, I don't know, 14, you missed the answer, you don't really recall that, then put it back to day one, and after one day, you are just going to again actively recall that answer. And those are the 11 tips that I highly recommend if you want to become a front-end developer. Now, if you did like this video, go ahead and check out how you can add subscriptions easily into your apps with the help of RevenueCAD. The video is right over here.